400 RPM.
It is not that far off, so once I get it round, it should be fine. It's pretty solid. It's a piece of ash. This tree was actually still surviving here in Michigan. Half of it was. The ash borer beetle killed half of it. This tree is struggling, but it was still surviving. Unfortunately, it was in my way, so I had to take it down.
Thank you.
It's a little big, but I need to fill a lot. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'll spray this down with mold release real good, and hopefully it comes loose. If not, I will turn it right off there. But, like, there's a lot of, yeah, that's punky in there. We'll dig some of that out. What color do you think I should use, you guys? That's a piece of ash. What do you think? I think it's moving. Oh, you know what? I won't be able to put this in the pressure pot. All right. Well, we're going to see how it goes without one. So a lot of people ask me, how do you cut that resin? It's a feel. It's get used to it. So in general, a sharp tool like this one is, not that you can see it, this one's freshly sharpened, I just got done sharpening it, isn't really ideal for this. So it tends to cause a lot of chip out. So, and if I put too much pressure on it, you get the chip out. So, it's all about pressure. You don't know how you get the ribbons, I'm not really pushing on it. If I push on it, you get this. Fix that, you just come into it a little easier until you're making that cut 360 all the way around. If it's bouncing, it's going to chip. And these cuts take a long time, so. You can hear it as it chips out a little bit. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. But you get asked. So, right. Yeah, here, move you guys. So, right. This is always a pain. Trying to make it so you can see what you're doing and keep you out of my way at the same time. Alright, so you can see where I pushed on it too hard, we got the chip out. I'm taking a pretty big bite also, So, but the chip out is based on the pressure. You put too much pressure on, especially with a sharp tool, you're going to get chip out. And the only way to get out of that chip out is to lightly take it off until you get past it. You can't just bite into it like that. So the speed at which I'm turning isn't helping me any either. It's 360 or 560 RPMs. In general, I like to turn at 1200. Much nicer cuts. So you got to come into it easy. Hear that chip out? Right here. So you can still hear that. Let me get here. You can still hear that when I was hitting it. But most of the chip out I've gotten rid of, you know, except for I didn't get into this up here. It's a feel. You got a feel for it. Everybody's asked, how do you cut like that? And Yep. It's just a kind of a finesse and a feel. Once you figure it out, it's there. Hopefully you get the idea. Most of this has to come off. I don't need it. So I'm just going to chip it all off there because that's what happens fastest. I'm trying to make the pretty cuts of practice, I guess. But I poured this not needing all that resin there. I just needed to fill cracks. I have some things to fill. I'm not even sure what I'm gonna do with that. Take too much time to go back through and try to do this with resin. I think I'll try to do it with UV resin, possibly. Just fill it in and cure it and call it good. So right here, it's still down a little bit, but I think I'll lose that when I clean the top of it up. For the most part, it looks okay, with the exception of some of these. This is a hole, that's a hole, and some of these have holes in them. That's because I couldn't put it in the pressure pot, I would say, anyway. So I need to clean this up a little bit more right here. Wow, it cut really nice this direction, and didn't cut really nice that direction. And this, I might be able to get in back here and come at it. Let me see. 8 grit up through 800. Sand 80 to 800 grit. I did not realize how hard ash was. I guess I haven't turned it yet. So yeah, let me get to that here. Ta-da! Okay, so I have never turned ash, apparently, and I didn't realize how hard it actually is. Now, I know I left the pits in there. I thought it looked kind of cool. I don't know if it's going to crack anymore. I can't feel them. I think I got most of them stabilized, so. It's really kind of cool. Normally, we don't leave that in there. The midnight purple stuff, it's got some air bubbles in it, and I'm like, you know what? It's gonna stay that way. And then, of course, my logo in the bottom. I think this is based on the colorations of it. It was a red, like my logo, my new stickers, where it's red and black, I think. And I think that's why it's doing that. The laser is seeing that and doing it. I know it's a black clip art that I have, but it's off a colored one. So I think that's why it looks like that, because it's kind of, see where it's darker and lighter? Well, that's how the sticker looks. So I think that's why it's like that. Pretty hard. That's just a bowl. I know, it's just a bowl. But that's my video for this week. A piece of ash. Now this ash is out of my yard, out back here. So if you followed the other channel, I had to move an ash in order to put my greenhouse in, or high tunnel, or whatever you want to call it. That being said, I will put some pictures at the end. Give her a thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs down if you didn't. And y'all have a good week, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.